Hi everyone, this is Victor here. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to invest like Warren Buffett. Specifically, I will talk about his 300 billion plus inflation-proof stock portfolio. I will talk about the three main rules to invest like Warren Buffett. To give you some context, at the time of making this video, the US inflation rate is at a 40-year high. The Russia-Ukraine crisis is causing oil and gas prices to reach new highs. The global supply chain issues are still ongoing and are increasing oil prices from raw materials to cheap components to shipping cost. And the US Fed injected too much money into the US economy through the quantitative easing program that started in 2020. Now the US Fed is expected to raise its interest rates aggressively going forward in order to tame the high inflation rate in the US. As a result, the US stock market, especially growth stocks, is in a large correction at the time of making this video. Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway is one of the few companies that still performs well when the US inflation rate is high. For example, Berkshire Hathaway stock has outperformed the S&P 500 by a large margin in the past 1 year, as well as in the past 2 years. In this video, I will talk about Warren Buffett's inflation-proof stock portfolio and how to invest like Warren Buffett. I will cover these topics. First, Warren Buffett's inflation-proof stock portfolio. I will explain why Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway and his 300 billion plus stock portfolio are inflation-proof. Second, why Berkshire Hathaway is beating the S&P 500 and Cathie Wood's ARK ETFs. We will compare Warren Buffett's stock portfolio with Cathie Wood's ARK Innovation ETF. And third, the three main rules to invest like Warren Buffett. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on the notification button. I will continue to make many excellent stock analysis and investing videos a week that will help you become a great investor. Also, if you like this channel and want to support it, check out my Patreon blog in the video description and become a premium member. Our goal is to create the best intelligent investor community that will help all our members grow their stock portfolio to over 7 figures over time. With your support, we'll be able to stay independent, hire other outstanding analysts to cover different stocks, and create many excellent stock analysis and investing videos every week that will help you become a great investor. The link is in the video description. Take a look, let's start. Before talking about Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway and his inflation-proof stock portfolio, I want to give you some context here. At the time of making this video, the US stock market is in a large correction for several major reasons. First, the US inflation rate is at a 40-year high because of the global supply chain issues, and because the US Fed injected too much money into the US economy in the past 2 years since the pandemic started in 2020. Second, many large fund managers have rotated their investments from high-growth stocks to value stocks, energy stocks, banks, utilities, consumer staples, and even real estate income trust REITs that will perform better when inflation rate is high. Third, the US Fed is expected to raise its interest rates aggressively going forward to tame the high inflation rate in the US. And fourth, the current Russia-Ukraine crisis is causing oil prices to reach over $120 a barrel. Higher oil and gas prices always lead to a high inflation rate in the US because oil and natural gas are large contributors to consumer prices in the US. Here is the interesting part about Warren Buffett's inflation-proof stock portfolio. Warren Buffett has around 47 stocks in his 300 billion plus stock portfolio. His top 4 holdings are Apple, Bank of America, Coca-Cola, and American Express. These top 4 holdings make up 72% of his 300 billion stock portfolio. If you look at Buffett's top 15 holdings here, most of these companies benefit a lot when inflation is high, especially banks and oil and gas companies. For example, Apple, the largest and most profitable tech company in the world, can often pass higher chip component costs to consumers by increasing the prices of iPhone, iPad, Mac, and iOS services. Bank of America, US Bank Corp, and Bank of New York Mellon Corp benefit a lot when interest rates are increasing. Banks tend to earn higher interest margins from consumer loans, business loans, and commercial loans when interest rates are high. American Express, one of the largest credit card companies in the US, also benefits when the US inflation rate is high. American Express card members will still use their Amex cards to buy things even when prices are higher, so they can earn high rewards and cash back. Coca-Cola, the largest soft drink company in the world, can often pass high inflation costs to consumers by increasing the prices of Coke, Sprite, and other soft drinks. Chevron and Occidental Petroleum benefit the most when oil and natural gas prices are high because they can earn higher profits. Kroger, one of the largest supermarkets in the US, can pass higher inflation costs to consumers by increasing the prices of groceries. In my opinion, all these businesses I mentioned are inflation-proof. They still benefit even when the US inflation rate is at a 40-year high. They can often pass higher costs to consumers, and consumers will still buy their products and services. So why is Berkshire Hathaway beating the S&P 500 and even ARK ETFs? Let me explain here. In addition to Berkshire's 300 billion plus stock portfolio, Berkshire runs some of the largest insurance businesses in the US, including Geico, Berkshire Hathaway Primary Group, and Berkshire Hathaway Reinsurance Group. Warren Buffett explains that Berkshire Hathaway has the four most important businesses that contribute the most value to Berkshire. He said this in the latest 2021 shareholder letter. Operations of our big four companies account for a very large chunk of Berkshire's value. Leading this list is our cluster of insurers. Berkshire effectively owns 100% of this group, whose massive float value we earlier described. The invested assets of these insurers are further enlarged by the extraordinary amounts of capital we invest to back up their promises. The insurance business is made to order for Berkshire. The product will never be obsolete, and sales volume will generally increase along with both economic growth and inflation. In addition to Berkshire's insurance business, the other three most important businesses are the 5.6% ownership in Apple, which is worth around $145 billion at the time of making this video, BNS Railway, which is one of the largest railroad companies in North America, and Berkshire Hathaway Energy. In my opinion, all these big four businesses are inflation-proof because they can often pass higher inflation costs, higher material costs, and higher shipping costs to your customers. He wrote, the insurance business is made to order for Berkshire. The product will never be obsolete, and sales volume will generally increase along with both economic growth and inflation. Berkshire's BNSF Railway and Berkshire's Hathaway Energy are essential services for many businesses and customers in North America. Based on my understanding, these two businesses can pass most of their inflation costs to their customers. If you look at Berkshire's latest 2021 annual report, you can see Berkshire's insurance underwriting, railroad, utilities, and energy businesses all reported higher earnings compared to the previous year. This suggests Berkshire's most important businesses, insurance, railroad, energy, and utilities, are generally inflation-proofed. I believe this is one of the main reasons Berkshire Hathaway has outperformed the S&P 500 by a large margin in the past 2 years. Another reason is that most of Berkshire's manufacturing, service, and retailing businesses have already recovered from the pandemic. This is why you can see Berkshire's earnings from manufacturing, service, and retailing in 2021 had already recovered from 2020 and 2019 levels. Berkshire Hathaway has also outperformed Cathie Wood's ARK Innovative ETF in the past 2 years since the beginning of 2020 when the pandemic started. The main reason is that Warren Buffett mainly invests in well-established companies that are already profitable, with durable economic moats, and with outstanding CEOs. Many of these businesses are inflation-proof. In comparison, Cathie Wood mainly invests in disruptive companies that will take years to become profitable. Many of these disruptive companies are still losing a lot of money every quarter. These companies are always impacted the most when the inflation rate is high and when interest rates are expected to increase. For example, if you look at ARK Innovation ETF here, you can see ARK mainly invests in disruptive companies such as Tesla, Teladoc, Roku, Zoom, Coinbase, and Exact Sciences. Most of these businesses are not profitable yet. Many of them are still losing a lot of money every quarter. This is why ARK ETFs have underperformed substantially since the beginning of 2021. To be fair, ARK ETFs will perform well when the inflation rate is low and when interest rates are expected to stay low. But we're in a high inflation rate environment now. Going forward, as long as the US inflation rate remains high, well above the US Fed's 2% target inflation rate, I believe Warren Buffett's Berkshire Hathaway will likely outperform the S&P 500 and Cathie Wood's ARK ETFs over the next 2 years. The main reason is that Buffett has invested in many businesses such as Geico, Apple, BNSF Railway, Berkshire Hathaway Energy, banking, and oil and gas businesses that are generally inflation-proof. Here's the important question, how to invest like Warren Buffett? The first most important rule is to see stocks as businesses for long-term investing. In a CNBC interview, Buffett said this, explaining why it's important to see stocks as businesses. I have no idea what the stock market is going to do tomorrow, or next week, or next month, or next year. If you own your stocks as an investment, just like you had to own an apartment, house, or a farm, look at them as a business. If you're going to try to buy and sell them based on news or something your neighbors tells you, you're not going to do well. Find a good bunch of businesses and hold them. Then he said, you will not make money trying to sell stocks daily or weekly. In the most recent 2021 shareholder letter, Buffett explained the importance of investing in businesses with durable competitive advantage, with a first-class CEO. He also said he and Charlie Munger are not stock pickers, but rather they are business pickers. He wrote, Berkshire owns a wide variety of businesses, some in their entirety, some only in part. part. The second group largely consists of marketable common stocks of major American companies. Additionally, we own a few non-US equities and participate in several joint ventures or other collaborative activities. Whatever our form of ownership, our goal is to have meaningful investments in businesses with both durable economic advantage and a first-class CEO. Please note particularly that we own stocks based upon our expectations about their long-term business performance and not because we view them as vehicles for timely market moves. That point is crucial. Charlie and I are not stock pickers, we are business pickers. I make many mistakes. Consequently, our extensive collection of businesses includes some enterprises that have truly extraordinary economics, many others that enjoy good economic characteristics, and a few that are marginal. One advantage of our common stock segment is that on occasion, it becomes easy to buy pieces of wonderful businesses at wonderful prices. That shooting fish in a barrel experience is very rare in negotiated transactions and never occurs en masse. It's also far easier to exit from a mistake when it has been made in the marketable arena. When we're investing in stocks, it's important to see them as businesses because stocks are essentially pieces of businesses that we own. Stocks are actual ownerships of businesses. Stocks are not stock tickers for us to trade every day, every week, or every month. If you're a business owner, it would not make sense for you to invest in a business today and sell your business the next day, or sell it the next week, or sell it the next month. If you're a business owner and you like to invest in businesses, you want to invest in wonderful businesses that have great economic moats at a fair price or an undervalued price. Then you want to keep your business for many years and let it grow over time and hold it as long as it continues to be a profitable business. Buffett suggests that we should see stocks as businesses we invest in for the long term, similar to how we invest in an apartment, a house, or a farm. Again, he said, you will not make money trying to sell stocks daily or weekly. In his 1988 shareholder letter, Buffett wrote, "In fact, when we own portions of outstanding businesses with outstanding management, our favorite holding period is forever. We're just the opposite of those who hurry to sell and book profits when companies perform well, but who tenaciously hang on to businesses that disappoint." Peter Lynch actually likens such behavior to cutting the flowers and watering the weeds. The second most important rule is to invest in wonderful businesses that have durable competitive advantage and a first-class CEO. Buffett wrote, "Whatever our form of ownership, our goal is to have meaningful investments in businesses with both durable economic advantage and a first-class CEO. This means we have to look for outstanding businesses that have durable economic moats that can protect the business from most competitors. Also, it's equally important to look for businesses that are run by outstanding CEOs that are shareholder-oriented. For example, I believe Google and Microsoft are two outstanding businesses with large economic moats run by two outstanding CEOs. Personally, I've had shares in Google and Microsoft for many years already. Google has a very large economic moat because it's almost impossible for competitors to compete with Google Search Engine and YouTube. Google Search Engine and YouTube are the two largest search engines in the world. Google also owns the Android operating system that's on most smartphones. When you buy a smartphone, you either choose an iPhone or a smartphone that runs Google's Android operating system. Microsoft also has a very large economic moat because the company owns Windows that's on almost all personal computers except Macs. Microsoft also owns Office 365 that is consisting of many other very popular Office applications. Microsoft for sure, which is one of the top 3 public cloud providers in the world, and Xbox game consoles. In my opinion, it's almost impossible for competitors to replace Microsoft Windows OS, Office 365 applications, Microsoft Azure, and Xbox game consoles. Another example is this. In Buffett's 2021 shareholder letter, Buffett praised Apple CEO Tim Cook for doing an outstanding job running Apple and returning a large amount of capital to Apple shareholders through dividends and share buybacks every year. Buffett invested about $36 billion in Apple between 2016 and 2018. Under Tim Cook's management, Buffett's stake in Apple is now worth $145 billion at the time of making this video. Personally, I've had Apple shares for many years already. In my opinion, it's not easy to know whether a company has a first-class CEO or a mediocre CEO because we do not get to meet the CEO in person and interview the CEO. However, I believe a first-class CEO is very shareholder-oriented. A first-class CEO would know how to increase the intrinsic value of the business by building excellent products and services and by building economic moats around the business without diluting existing shareholders' ownerships and without using too much debt. If the CEO is doing an outstanding job, the company's yearly business performance will reflect it. Also, it's important to stay within your circle of competency and only invest in the businesses you understand the most. For example, if you know a lot about oil and gas businesses, it will not make sense for you to invest in tech companies you do not understand at all. Buffett always stays within his circle of competencies by investing in banks and oil and gas businesses because he understands these businesses the most. The third most important rule is to invest in stocks at wonderful prices. This means you want to invest in a stock only when it's undervalued, so there will be a good margin of safety to reduce risk. The stock price does not tell us anything about the business. The stock price only tells us what price Mr. Market is willing to sell to you today, or what price Mr. Market is willing to buy from you today. For example, if you look at Google stock price, you may think it's very expensive because it traded at $2,500 per share at the time of making this video. But this price does not tell you anything about Google's business. The stock price only tells you that Mr. Market is willing to sell you a piece of Google's business for $2,500 per share today, or Mr. Market is willing to buy your piece of Google's business for $2,500 per share today. Here is the important part you want to know. The stock price does not always reflect the intrinsic value of the business because Mr. Market can be very irrational from time to time. Mr. Market can be very pessimistic today and very optimistic the next day, next week, or next month. At the time of making this video, Mr. Market is extremely pessimistic and fearful because of the Russia-Ukraine crisis and the high inflation rate in the US. This means many stocks are likely traded below their intrinsic business values. I learned this from studying Warren Buffett for many years. The intelligent investor will want to buy a piece of a wonderful business only when the stock is traded below its intrinsic value. I always use this intrinsic value calculator to calculate a business intrinsic value before buying the stock. If you want this intrinsic value calculator, you can download it in my Patreon blog in the video description. For example, I use this intrinsic value calculator and estimated Google's intrinsic value to be around $3,621 per share. Under the worst case scenario, I estimated Google's intrinsic value to be around $2,950 per share. In comparison, Morningstar estimated Google's fair value to be around $3,600 per share. This means I believe Google is undervalued by around 30% at the time of making this video. Here's the key takeaway. If you want to invest like Warren Buffett, see stocks as businesses for long-term investing. Invest as though you're buying the whole business. Stay within your circle of competency and invest in a group of wonderful businesses at wonderful prices. Now, all these are only my opinions and my analysis based on my research. They are not financial advice. You will need to do your own research and do your extra due diligence first before investing in anything. Thank you for watching this video and supporting our channel. This is Victor from the Intelligent Investor channel, and I will see you in the next video.